Welcome to Art History with Jackie. In our last lesson of August, we will be exploring the history of printmaking, joined later at Art on the Deck by local artist Michael Heffer. Printmaking techniques are generally divided into the following categories. A relief, where ink is applied to the original surface of the matrix. Relief techniques include woodcut or block, wood engraving, and lino cut. Intaglio, where ink is applied beneath the original surface of the matrix. Intaglio techniques include engraving, etching, mezzo tint, and aquatint. Planographic, where the matrix retains its original surface, but is prepared or inked to allow for the transfer of an image. Techniques include lithography, monotyping, and digital techniques. And finally, stencil, where ink or paint is pressed through a prepared screen, including screen printing and pochoir. Before the printing press, printmaking was not considered an art form, but rather a medium of communication. It was not until the 18th century that art prints began to be considered originals, and not until the 19th century that artists began to produce limited editions. Engraving goes back to cave art, executed on stones, bones, and cave walls. The duplication of engraved images goes back some 3,000 years to the Sumerians, who engraved designs on stone cylinder seals. European printmaking began with textile printing, while printing on paper had to wait a bit longer for the arrival of paper technology from Asia. The first woodcuts printed on paper were playing cards produced in Germany at the beginning of the 15th century. Printing from a metal engraving was introduced a few decades after the woodcut and greatly refined the results. This soon became the most popular form of serial reproduction. The earliest dated printed engraving is a German print dated 1446, titled The Flagellation, and it was in Germany as well that early intaglio printing developed before passing over to Italy. From makers of playing cards, the metal engraving technique passed to artists, where it reached its apex in the hands of Albrecht Dürer in the 16th century. His name just keeps coming up, doesn't it? The 17th century saw a flowering of ornamental and portrait work all over Europe. Europe's printmaking center of gravity moved to Italy in the 18th century, beginning with Tiepolo and then Canaletto, the chronicler of Venice and Piranesi. He was the most important architectural printmaker of all time, with some 3,000 architectural etchings. Distinguished English printmaking begins with Hogarth in the 18th century. The Japanese printing style, known as ukiyo-e, depicted woodcuts of the floating world and represented a drastic break with the classical artistic tradition. These images were highly stylized and thoroughly refined. In the 19th century, France dominated the printmaking world. The discovery of Japanese color woodcuts was a revelation that influenced European art. As trade relations opened up with Japan, color prints came into the hands of Parisian artists. The simple handling of color and design represented a totally new visual experience. Paul Gauguin was one who profited greatly from their influence, producing several boldly colored prints. The most famous Japanese master of woodcut was Hokusai. He was interested in history and mythology, popular customs, animal life, and landscape. One of his most famous works is The Breaking Wave off Kanagawa, which you may be familiar with. The invention of photography in the early 1800s had a great influence on printmaking. It made reproductive printmaking obsolete, and printmaking returned to the creative artists. France continued to be the center of the art world at this point. Edvard Munch was an artist who made outstanding etchings, dry points, color lithographs, and experimental woodcuts. Pablo Picasso was also one of the most dramatic figures of contemporary graphic art. He made well over 1,000 prints. After the mid-20th century, there was an exponential increase in printmaking activity. Artists all over the world began to experiment with the medium. More technical innovations were introduced after the mid-20th century than in the entire previous history of printmaking. Artists continue to innovate and play with the medium to this day. Let's see how Mike employs his artistic hand when manipulating the medium. See you this afternoon.